If you're ready to build your own approval process custom for your specific workflow, look no further than this video. I'm going to be breaking down for you how you can create step by step a very simple approval process in Airtable. So if learning about this is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools so that you can build your own apps and workflows without needing any code. In this video, we're going to be diving into Airtable, specifically how you can build a very simple approval process in the software that's going to go through three different approval requirements before the request is officially approved. Before we get into the video though, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. If you're new to Airtable, the basics are really easy to master if you go step by step, and I will teach those to you in my free Airtable crash course. You can sign up for that at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I'll include links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and we're going to break down exactly how we built this. Now, this whole thing came together in a matter of minutes, and I have even included the interface components for you as well so that you can see kind of how this whole process works. So let's jump into the back end first. Now, what we're looking at here is the data layer in Airtable, and this is where we build all of the different tables and the links and the formulas and the different fields. Now, for this example, we have built a single table. We don't have any linked relationships, nothing else happening. Now, this is not the only way to do this, but this is the simplest way that you can build an approval process. Now, that being said, you're going to notice that we have some information that we're collecting about the request. So here I've included a name, an item URL, a date created, a requested amount, and who it was requested by. And since I'm currently in Europe setting up our new team here in the EMEA markets, I'm using Euros and Amazon Spain as an example. So if things look a little different than usual, that's why. Now, if we scroll on over here, you're going to see some additional fields. Now, we've got three different decisions, as I mentioned, and these are single select fields, and they are identical to one another, except by their numbering. So we've got a pending status, which is the default status. So when we create a new request, it's automatically going to be in a pending decision. And then the user can either choose to approve or reject it. And it's going to go through three different layers of that approval. And so in this way, we're able to actually build multiple steps in our approval process, and it's all living in that same record. And this is the simplest form of this solution. Now, I should say that we could also build multi-table solutions where we link to other records. But since this is the simplest form and we're trying to get this up and running quickly, we are not going to be linking to other tables here. We are focused on the simple solution. So decisions 1, 2, and 3, all exactly the same. And here we have our request status. Now, this is basically looking at the three different request decisions, and it's determining whether the whole thing is approved, whether it's rejected, or if it's still in a pending status. Now, I can go through and teach you how to write these formulas, but the truth is the AI here can build a pretty good formula for you just with common language. So you can just type into the prompt what you're trying to do and get an outcome like this. And we have three different outcomes. This whole thing can be approved. That would be request approved. We could also do the whole thing is rejected, or we're still waiting. And so over here on the formatting, you're going to see that we've got the three different options color coded in single select fields. And as the status here is updated, if we get a single rejection, we would expect that overall status to then flag rejected, which it does. Similarly, if I have all three of them approved, then that's going to move us into the approval status. And so by this formula, we're able to see what the overall status is based on the three different decisions. And then we also have this link here. And so for our example, we're imagining that someone is submitting for budget request, and we're looking at the item URL. That's the field here at the beginning that we were looking at, in this case, an Amazon link. And so we can simply give them a button that they can push and open quickly, just with the quick tap there, and find the item in question. So that's how our basic setup works on the back end. Nothing too complicated, and as I said, comes together in just a matter of minutes. Now let's take a look at some interfaces that we've built. Number one, the ability to look at my requests. So here we can see the different requests that we've put in. We've also conditionally filtered this particular interface to only show the things that I've put in. Now, of course, I'm the only one working in this example database, so all of the data is mine. Now, if we're to dive into this, here I can click on the overall page and look at those filter conditions. They are filtered down to only reflect the records of the current user. Now, this means that multiple people could access this system. They could all submit their own requests. Who submits that request is metadata that's cataloged by Airtable. And then we can filter it so that people only see their requests in this view. So this type of filterability in the interfaces makes it a really easy to customize solution, and we can make sure that people only see the data that's relevant to them. Now, similarly, we could have similar filters in the decisions. So let's say there are three different decision makers that need to go through the steps. We could filter and share those different interfaces only with the people who need that access. We could even hide these interfaces entirely from somebody else if they don't have the proper status to, you know, make a decision. So in this way, we can really lock down who has access to what data and therefore protect data for the overall organization and create workflows that, you know, really get the job done without showing things to people that shouldn't see them. Okay, so we've got here our ability to add a request as well. Let's go back into the app. I'm going to add a new request here. Let's say, you know, I did a little search for an office chair. I'm going to grab this address here and I'll drop it in here. I'll just say office chair. I think it was around 240 euro, somewhere around there. And let's go ahead and share that link. And we can create a new request just that simply. And you can see the whole thing was put together for us here. And I can open up the link and it's going to take me right back there. Okay, so now that we've got that in play, let's take a look at some different examples for how we can go through the decision process. Now, first I'm sharing a Kanban view. And I've filtered this down to only show us the decision number one. So imagine that we are looking at decision number one here. Maybe I'm the first manager who has to approve or reject. So I've got two approvals here. I just saw that new office chair request. I can click this link to open it up. I can see who requested it and the dollar amount or euro in this case. And then I can make a decision. I've enabled editing for this user and this page so they could drag this into approved or rejected. Let's say I reject this one. Of course, the person who requested it then is going to see that that request is rejected. And if there were some notes, we could include that here as well as to why something might have been rejected. Now let's take me back to decision one and take a look at this Microsoft Surface laptop. Let's say I want to approve this one. I click the link, I look at it, I approve this request, and I drop it into the approved status. Now let's imagine that this is a linear approval status. So that would mean that over here, decision two should now see that showing up here. So here we've used a different type of interface page. This is a record review page, where we filter in the information here to only show us those records that have already been approved on decision number one. And so if I were to go back to decision one and move this back into pending, I don't see the Microsoft Surface laptop in decision two yet. Again, this is imagining it's linear. It doesn't have to be built this way, but in this example, I'm imagining that it goes from decision one, two, and three. So once decision one approves that, then I'm gonna see it here. But you'll notice that decision two has not made their mind yet. So I'll drill into that Microsoft Surface laptop and I'll update decision two. Imagine that I am now taking the role of manager number two and I am approving this. So great, it's now been moved down into this section and it's approved. Now that's gonna put it into decision number three's pile. And here we've built a custom interface using Airtable's new AI custom interface elements. Now, if you're not familiar with these, we did feature this in a previous video, and I really love that we can build new custom interface pages like this. If you want to see how to do that, of course, watch that video. And here I've opened up Omni. We can look at the history here of all chats. You can see that I built this entire interface page with just two prompts. So it came together really quickly. Let's go back to the interface itself, and you can see that I can just quickly decide if something is going to get improved from pending over to approved or rejected. I can also simply click here and open up the link and make a decision. So let's say I approve that Microsoft Surface laptop, just like that. Now, whoever put that request in, they are going to see that that request is approved. And so it's moved all the way down the three different decisions, and it's all in one simple table and shared within four different interfaces. Now, I know we went quickly in this video, but this is a high-level example of how you can build your own custom approval process. Of course, there are hundreds of thousands of different directions you could take this. Everyone's process is a little different, but I hope that this gave you an example of how to get started. Of course, if you have questions that we did not answer in this video, I'd encourage you to swing by our website. We have a ton of resources available, and we offer free inquiry calls if you'd like to talk about how we can work together to help you improve your own systems. Of course, if you got value from this video, we'd love it if you could give it a thumbs up, maybe subscribe to the channel if you want more content like this. But most importantly, my friends, keep on building.